Ah, how can anyone forget him? His not-so-gay go-to tricks. That Andrew Reynolds-like fruit diet. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, we're talking about, nonetheless, Mr. Forrest Edwards. Now, if you just don't remember who Forrest Edwards is, he was a young gun that was launched into fame through a discontinued show called One in a Million that was in collab with Mountain Dew.
I'm Forrest Edwards, I'm 20 years old, and I'm from Riverside, California. My strengths are my pure determination. You can see it in my eyes. Of course I'm trying to win. I wouldn't want to come down here just for an experience. My go-to tricks aren't that gay.
Well, it is safe to say that Forrest really wasn't the most humble individual we've stumbled across. But hey, I'll give it to you. You're a pretty darn good skater. After the show was aired and eventually discontinued, Forrest pretty much was launched into stardom and fame all at the same time. It happened pretty fast. Several big companies were interested in him. We're talking about Toy Machine and Zero, among others. What ended up happening is that Forrest ended up getting flowed by Zero, and Jamie Thomas even went about making this special edition board of Black Jesus. Now, right before Forrest was officially on the team, and these boards were officially on sale, out of nowhere, in 2015, we found out that Jamie Thomas / Zero kicked Forrest off the team. Now, naturally, whenever this first happened, everyone and their mamas wanted to know what exactly happened, what took place, so everybody asked questions. Fortunately, Jamie Thomas kept it very professional and never really gave away too much detail onto what exactly happened between them. Now, until a year later, 2016, recently Jamie Thomas opened up and explained a little bit more in what exactly happened with the Forrest and Zero situation. According to a recent Riot Channel article, he stated, quote, "His footage was all over the place and with a bunch of different people. When we finally got it all together, some of it had been used. He had tons of repeats and a lot of HD fisheye, which isn't the best format of professional skateboarding videos. So we didn't really have a part. He also only had one sequence for his interview. And after three months of reminding him, he still didn't have an ad. So I sat down with him, trying to work things out, and pretty much ended up making a decision, which told him he couldn't be on the team anymore. Apparently he cracked under pressure. That's what happened to Forrest and Zero. Now, guys, I gotta be completely honest. I really like this guy. He's an amazing athlete. He can do lots of things on his board. Therefore, he has earned my respect. But to be completely honest, he has unfortunately given us proof that he can be arrogant. He can be full of himself. Therefore, he can be difficult to work with. And that's exactly what Jamie Thomas saw and ultimately told him that this was not going to be a good choice for both of them. Therefore, he made that decision. So I respect that. So is there a lesson to be learned here? Absolutely. No matter what career you're in, no matter what field you're in, no matter how much talent you believe you have, if you cannot commit to deadlines and work well under pressure, you will never be as successful to your maximum potential. That is a certainty. Guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Go ahead and give it a thumbs up if you liked it. And like always, I am the Skin Informant. You've been informed, so my job here is done. I'll finish off the video with my favorite part out of this video in a really funny Forrest Edwards interview. Hope you guys enjoy. Take care. Peace.
Got the big flip. Not really trying. The back three was first try, so I didn't even break a sweat off that. I pretty much jumped down it like only like 10 times.